Montreal is a city built on an island in the St. Lawrence River, and it's growing fast. As more people move to the surrounding suburbs on the mainland, commutes have lengthened and traffic has intensified, especially on Montreal's bridges. These bridges often feel like bottlenecks, turning any trip into a grind. During rush hour, crossing them can feel like an obstacle course, with everyone trying to reach their destinations through only a few available lanes. Meanwhile, Montreal-Trudeau International Airport, a major gateway to the city, lacks a direct rail connection. With air travel on the rise, a fast and reliable transit option is increasingly necessary. Montreal's metro system has not expanded in over 16 years. Instead of pursuing a costly metro extension, the city chose to develop a light rail system, the Réseau Express Métropolitain. Inspired by Paris's transit network, Montreal's REM aims to address these challenges directly. In this video, we'll explore the story behind the REM, its origins, scope, and how it is set to reshape the future of transit in Montreal, bringing the city one step closer to becoming a leader in modern urban transportation. The concept of a comprehensive regional express system for Montreal began to take shape in 2015. In January of that year, Quebec Premier Philippe Couillard and Michael Sabia, CEO of the Caisse de dépôt et placement du Québec, or just CDPQ, Quebec's provincial pension fund, entered into a strategic partnership to explore financing options for major infrastructure projects. This ambitious plan projected $7.4 billion Canadian dollars for provincial infrastructure from 2014 to 2024. Two critical projects were identified, a South Shore line and a line to the West Island, known as the Trandle West. These two routes later merged to form the core of the REM project, establishing CDPQ's role as a driving force in Montreal's transit future. It might seem unusual for the government to partner with a pension fund, but this is not the first time. CDPQ, managing around $420 billion Canadian dollars in assets, oversees pensions for various Quebec employees, including teachers, civil servants, and municipal workers, consolidating these resources into one powerful economic entity. CDPQ has also been involved in major infrastructure projects, such as leading construction on Vancouver's Canada Line, part ownership of Eurostar, and construction of the Sydney Metro. For Montreal, CDPQ Infra, the infrastructure branch of CDPQ, proposed to independently design, finance, and build the REM, offering the city and province a new public transit network without the risk of budget overruns. Under this unique arrangement, CDPQ receives a guaranteed annual return on its investment, while the government gains a vital transportation solution. This project also allows CDPQ to expand its infrastructure portfolio, potentially opening doors for similar projects in other cities. The Quebec government found the proposal highly attractive and approved it in 2016. The financial model supporting the REM is innovative, designed to secure long-term revenue for CDPQ. Once the REM is operational, the Metropolitan Regional Transportation Authority will pay CDPQ Infra amount of $0.7 per kilometer traveled by each passenger, with this rate adjusted for inflation. CDPQ expects a return of around 8-9% over the project's 99-year term. While fare revenues from the REM will not be allocated to other transit projects or agencies, CDPQ has emphasized that this revenue will help fund Quebec's pension system, meaning that every REM trip contributes to the financial well-being of Quebec's retirees. Additionally, CDPQ assumes all financial risk associated with the project, freeing the provincial government and municipalities from potential liabilities. The construction of REM, estimated at $6.5 billion, is primarily funded by CDPQ, which contributed $3.6 billion. The government of Quebec and the government of Canada each provided $1.3 billion, with an additional $295 million coming from Hydro-Quebec. In 2016, the REM project was officially announced. Spanning 67 kilometers with 26 strategically placed stations, the REM is designed to maximize connectivity across Montreal's metropolitan area. Once completed, it will be one of the world's largest automated transportation systems, ranking as the fourth largest. The network will include 15 stations on the Deux-Montagnes line, 4 stations on the South Shore, 4 stations towards Saint-Anne-de-Bellevue, and 2 serving the airport. For perspective, Montreal's current metro network covers 71 kilometers, making the REM a transformative addition to the city's transit infrastructure. Though the REM is a single integrated network, it will serve 3 distinct markets, each with unique commuting demands and transit needs. The South Shore, made up of Montreal's suburban communities along the southern bank of the St. Lawrence River, is a rapidly growing area with over 920,000 residents. As the population grows, so does the need for efficient commuting options in downtown Montreal. Currently, this demand is met by express bus services crossing Champlain Bridge, but REM's South Shore branch will offer a more efficient and reliable alternative. The West Island and Deux-Montagnes lines cater to a similar commuter-driven market, connecting Montreal's western suburbs to the downtown area. The West Island, known for its low-density residential and commercial areas, has around 240,000 residents, many of whom commute to the city center. Currently, these needs are met through a mix of rail services and bus routes feeding into Montreal's metro network. Meanwhile, the airport line targets a different market, travelers and airport employees commuting to and from Pierre-Elliott-Trudeau Airport. At present, transit options to the airport are limited, with most travelers relying on the 747 bus route, which connects the airport to the Berry-UQAM station in downtown Montreal. The primary route of the REM follows the historic Mount Royal Tunnel, where new underground stations are being constructed to connect with the existing McGill and Edouard Montpetit metro stations along the Blue Line. Operating since 1918, the Mount Royal Tunnel is Canada's third longest rail tunnel, linking Montreal's central station downtown with the northern part of the island and Laval, passing through Mount Royal. This horseshoe-shaped tunnel, measuring 5 kilometers in length, has been repurposed for the REM project. To accommodate the new side platform stations, 2 stations are being built within the tunnel by expanding its interior. CDPQ Infra evaluated the tunnel's condition to ensure it met fire safety standards, ultimately deciding to install a center wall within the double-track tunnel for added safety rather than opting for more extensive and costly tunneling work. One of the project's most complex elements is the interchange at Edouard Montpetit station, where the REM line connects with the metro's Blue Line. The tunnel lies 70 meters below the metro station, requiring a large shaft to be drilled into the granite to allow seamless passenger transfers. This shaft will house essential infrastructure, including elevators, emergency stairways, power cables, ventilation systems, and communication links to the REM platforms, ensuring efficient and accessible transfers. Central Station will connect with the Orange Line at Bonaventure. Southeast of Central Station, the REM follows existing rail lines until it reaches Marcantin Street, where it transitions to an elevated guideway that crosses to Nance Island. From there, the line uses a dedicated rail deck on the new Champlain Bridge to cross the St. Lawrence River. The existing Mount Royal Tunnel has enabled the REM project to avoid extensive tunneling and deep station construction, which would have significantly increased the project's complexity and cost. Additionally, using the new Champlain Bridge equipped with a dedicated rail deck for the South Shore line, has streamlined the construction process. On the northwest branch, the REM will convert a Deux Montagnes commuter line by adding a second track beyond Bois-Franc station and eliminating all at-grade crossings. The new airport branch, diverging from the main line near the A13, will serve Technopark Montreal before terminating at Montreal-Trudeau International Airport, and it includes an entirely new underground line that runs below the international airport airstrips. The overall underground stretch consists of approximately 3.6 kilometers. The main West Island branch will follow an existing freight rail line through Pointe-Claire, then parallel the A40 past Saint-Jean Boulevard and Kirkland, ultimately reaching Sainte-Anne-de-Bellevue. Much of this section will be elevated to avoid level crossings, ensuring a smooth and uninterrupted service. In June 2016, CDPQ Infra launched two major public tenders. One was for engineering, procurement and construction, and the other was for rolling stock, systems and operation and maintenance services. After nearly 2 years of evaluating bids, CDPQ Infra announced the selected contractors in February 2018. The EPC contract was awarded to the Group Nouve LR Consortium, which includes firms such as SNC-Lavalin, Grants Projects, Dragados, Aecon, Pomerleau and EBC. The rolling stock contract was awarded to a joint venture between Alstom and SNC-Lavalin. Together, these contracts were valued at an estimated $6.3 billion. The rolling stock contract, valued at $2.8 billion, covered automatic signaling, maintenance, operation services, and a supply of 212 Alstom Metropolis cars, forming 106 two-car trains. Built at Alstom's plant in India, these trains were shipped to Montreal for final integration. They are fully automated, operating without a driver or attendant on board. During quieter periods, the trains run as single two-car units and expand to four-car train sets during rush hour. Each two-car train seats 64 passengers and can accommodate around 300 standing, while four-car train sets hold up to 780 passengers during peak times. Three design concepts were presented to the public for a vote, and the winning concept, called Saint-Laurent, was inspired by the St. Lawrence River. This design features a light and dark green stripe, along with a light green outline around the train's front. White LED headlights cascade towards the center of the train, evoking the cables on the new Samuel de Champlain Bridge, adding a distinctive touch to the train's visual identity. Preparatory work for the REM project kicked off in late March 2018, and by April 12th, the official groundbreaking ceremony marked the start of Montreal's largest transit project in recent history. But as construction progressed, the century-old Mount Royal Tunnel posed a series of unforeseen challenges. This tunnel required significant updates to meet modern safety standards, and it quickly became the project's most complex obstacle. In 2020, work was suspended for 3 months after leftover explosives from the tunnel's original construction unexpectedly detonated. Following this incident, Quebec's health and safety authorities mandated that all drilling in the tunnel be carried out with remote robotic equipment. Years of exposure to de-icing salts had also degraded the tunnel walls, leading engineers to reinforce and rebuild parts of the structure to ensure long-term stability and safety. These tunnel issues, along with the impacts of the COVID-19 pandemic, labor shortages and supply chain delays, have delayed project inauguration and resulted with cost overruns. As a result, project costs are now projected to exceed the initial estimate, with the updated budget set at $8 billion. Importantly, these overruns of $1.7 billion were absorbed by CDPQ Infra, not the government, which increased CDPQ's equity share in the project by an additional 8%. Despite these setbacks, the REM project celebrated a major milestone on July 31, 2023, when the first five stations opened, linking Central Station to Brossard on the South Shore with a 17-kilometer-long automated line. The grand opening, held a few days prior on July 28, brought together leaders from all levels of government, including Prime Minister Justin Trudeau, Quebec Premier François Legault, and Montreal Mayor Valérie Plante. Free rides over the opening weekend attracted over 20,000 riders on the first day alone, highlighting public enthusiasm for the REM. By September 2023, the system had already carried more than 1 million passengers, with daily ridership averaging over 30,000. According to Bloomberg Research, this project stands out among recent North American transit projects and offers valuable lessons for other cities. At 67 kilometers, the REM is larger than many recent subway expansions. For perspective, New York's 2nd Avenue subway added just 3 kilometers, and Los Angeles' D-Line extension spans 14 kilometers. One of the most remarkable aspects of the REM is its cost-effectiveness. Even with recent budget increases to $8 billion Canadian dollars, including $1.7 billion in overruns, the REM's cost per mile is far lower than comparable projects across North America. With a total cost equivalent to about $5.8 billion US dollars, this translates to roughly $139 million per mile. In comparison, data from the Transit Cost Project at New York University's Maron Institute reveals that other transit projects are significantly more costly. On a per-mile basis, Los Angeles's D-Line extension costs $1.4 billion per mile, while New York's planned 2nd Avenue subway extension is estimated at an astounding $4.3 billion per mile. In the San Francisco Bay Area, a BART extension to Silicon Valley costs $2 billion per mile and is expected to serve fewer than half the riders that the REM's first phase already serves. The REM project also progressed at an impressive pace, moving from its initial announcement in 2016 to the opening of its first phase in 2023 in just 7 years. By handling the design, financing, construction, and now operations as a single entity, CDPQ Infra avoided many of the delays and cost increases that often arise from negotiations between multiple agencies and contractors. Quebec even passed a law requiring municipalities to respond promptly to requests from CDPQ Infra for permits and approvals, eliminating bureaucratic delays that can slow down other projects. This political support also allowed CDPQ Infra to construct much of the line as an elevated system, which is significantly less costly than underground construction. While the South Shore section of the REM is fully operational, construction is ongoing for the northern and western branches. According to the latest schedule, the segments covering the West Island, North Shore, and Central Montreal are still underway, with specific completion dates yet to be confirmed. The airport segment is expected to open in 2027. As Montreal's REM continues to expand, we'll keep sharing updates, insights, and in-depth coverage of this transformative project. If you find our content valuable and would like to support us in bringing you more quality videos, consider joining us on Patreon, YouTube membership, or supporting us through PayPal. Your support makes a real difference and helps us keep creating detailed content on the REM and other global transit projects. Thank you for being part of our community, and see you next time.